Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and in this video we will see what is system on chip. So today we are living in the era of a smartphone and a tablet, and in the past decade the technology has been evolved so much that using this smartphone and tablet we can do almost all the stuff that we were used to do with a desktop and a laptop. So using this smartphone and tablet we can do a stuff like gaming, web browsing, photo editing, creating documents, media streaming and many more things. And yet these devices are quite compact compared to the desktop and a laptop. And yet they contains almost all the parts which you see inside the desktop and a laptop. So almost all the components that you see inside the motherboard of any laptop or a desktop are integrated inside a single chip in the smartphone. So the entire system which is required to run a smartphone is integrated inside a single chip, and that is known as a SoC or a system on chip. And thanks to the leading manufacturers like Qualcomm, Samsung, Apple and MediaTek, it is possible to integrate all the components inside a single chip. And sometimes if you see the size of this system on chip, they are as small as size of a coin. So now the question is, how is it possible to integrate all the parts inside a single chip? So there are many reasons behind that. So let's find out these reasons. The first reason is the processors which you see inside the smartphone are not as powerful as processors which you find inside the desktop and the laptop. So don't get me wrong that the processors which you see inside smartphone are powerful enough, but if you compare them with the processors of desktop and laptop, the processors in desktop and laptop are quite powerful. So if you have seen any motherboard of any laptop or a desktop, you must have observed that the processor is enclosed by the heatsink and the cooling fan, because these powerful processors generates a lots of amount of heat, and they need some sort of cooling. So just imagine the size of your smartphone if the same processor with all the cooling arrangement is fit into your smartphone. And forget about the cooling, if you put this processor inside your smartphone, then your battery of the smartphone would be died in just half an hour, because these processors are quite power hungry and requires a lot of amount of power. So the fact is that the processors which you see inside a smartphone and tablet are designed using a different architecture. So the most of the processors which you see inside a smartphone and tablet are designed using the ARM architecture. And the system on chips which is designed using this ARM architecture are quite powerful as well as the power efficient. One more thing is that the operating system which is designed for this smartphone is optimized for this system on chips. So although on paper this smartphone processor doesn't look powerful compared to the desktop processors, but because of this software optimization, you hardly feel any lag when you are operating this smartphone and tablets. Apart from that, the advancement in the manufacturing technology has allowed us to integrate more and more transistors inside a same area. So not only in the smartphone, but in desktop and laptop also, you will see that many parts are integrated inside a same chip. So these are the some of the reasons why we are able to integrate all the components inside a single chip. So now as we know about what is system on chip, now let's find out what is inside this system on chip. So the first thing that you find inside the system on chip is the processor, and we have talked so much about this processor. So the next thing that you will see inside the SoC is the GPU, which is known as a graphical processing unit, and it is responsible for all the graphics related activity inside your smartphone or a tablet. The next thing that you will see inside the system on chip is the DSP, which is known as a digital signal processor, and it is responsible for the activities related to audio processing, video processing and somewhat related to display. So in some system on chips, you will find this audio and video processing module as a different module, while in some cases they are integrated inside a same module. The next thing that you will see inside this system on chip is the memory element, which contains the storage memory, that is a read-only memory, and the volatile memory, that is a random access memory. So now the next module that you will see inside the system on chip is the connectivity module. And this module ensures that the user have all kinds of connectivity like Wi-Fi, FM radio, USB, Bluetooth, sometimes GPS and cellular radios. So these are the basic modules that you will see inside the system on chip. Apart from this, some higher end system on chips also contain some other modules like a module for the camera, location, security and the sensors. Now sometimes due to the size constraint, it is not possible to integrate the random access memory or a RAM inside this system on chip. So in such scenarios, this memory package is stacked above this system on chip package, and they are connected using this ball grid array. So this kind of packaging arrangement is known as a package on package arrangement. And this type of package on package arrangement reduces the cost as well as the size. Now, in scenarios where the memory is outside the system on chip, you need to establish the connection between the CPU and the memory. And that is done by the module known as a North Bridge. So, this module ensures the connectivity between the RAM and the CPU. So, these are the modules you will find inside the today's system on chip. So far, this system on chip technology is more or less limited to the smartphone and the tablets. But in the near future, you will see this system on chips in almost all the devices and in the all the applications. So now the question is, what about the desktop and the laptop processors? So the answer is, they will be still used in the applications where the size and the power consumption is not an issue and you require an intensive amount of processing. So the applications like the supercomputers and servers, they still will be preferred over the system on chips. So I hope in this video you understood what is system on chip. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.